Today we're checking out a standout, the Minisforum AtomMan X70i. Let's break down what makes this PC special and see if it's worth your time and money. Buckle up, subscribe, and let's unbox this thing. Here's the X70i. First impression? Slick. A premium aluminium build that feels solid and substantial. Alongside, there's an adjustable stand, a 120 watts power adapter, a power cable, and short HDMI cable. That's everything you need to get started. Let's dive into the design. This PC has a solid aluminium build, definitely not something you'd hide away. On the front, there are two USB A 3.2 ports, a USB C 4, a 3.5mm combo jack, and a CMOS reset button. Cooling vents are on the left side. Around back, you'll find more USB A ports, 3.2 and 2.0, another USB C 4, HDMI display ports, RJ45 ports, and an Oculink port for external GPU. On the right, it's got an SD card reader, a privacy cover for the camera, and a power button with a fingerprint sensor. A nice security touch. The stand tilts the unit up for better airflow through a vent underneath. Up top, there's a touchscreen and a camera, which is great for face unlock. That adds some extra security, and don't forget the privacy blind if you prefer to cover the camera. Both face unlock and a fingerprint reader can be set up during initial Windows installation or later in the settings. Setup is straightforward. Connect a wired mouse and a keyboard to install the Windows 11 Home Edition, then you can get full-on wireless with Bluetooth. You can choose between a fresh install or restore from backup. Once you're set up, the touchscreen shows system stats like CPU usage, RAM and network traffic, and you can switch between performance modes or display a clock. The screen is set to Chinese by default, but you can switch to English or other languages pretty easy. The screen functions as a mini dashboard, but right now it feels more like a gimmick unless they would add more practical features like app notifications or emails. Hopefully that comes in future updates. And a pro tip. Keep this PC upright for optimal airflow. That will prevent the screen from flipping upside down or the camera pointing at the ceiling. The cooling system pulls air from below and vents it near the power button, which helps keep the powerful CPU running cool. What makes this mini PC stand out? It's powered by an Intel Core Ultra 9 featuring 16 cores, 22 threads and a turbo boost up to 5.1 GHz on performance cores. It's overkill for daily tasks, but perfect for heavy multitasking or video editing. This is one of the new Meteor Lake chips, branded Core Ultra instead of just 14th gen. It also includes Intel Arc graphics, which are decent for light gaming or creative tasks. The PC supports dual-channel DDR5 RAM, and there are plenty of PCI lanes for high bandwidth. It also features an Oculink port for external GPU upgrades, which allows for significant graphics enhancements. While there's no Thunderbolt support, Oculink actually makes a smarter, future-proof choice for raw data transfer speed. While this PC includes USB 4, please note, the USB 4 and Thunderbolt are not the same, even though they use the same connector. USB 4 can't handle an external GPU as efficiently as Thunderbolt can, but Oculink outperforms both in speed. This mini PC is also one of the first to rock Wi-Fi 7, which is ridiculously fast. If you happen to own one of the three routers on the planet that support it, and let's be real, most of us don't, so instead you've got dual 5GBE LAN ports, which are great for high-speed networking, up to 1000 megabits per second. Nice. Plus, there are dual SODIMM slots for up to 96 gigs of DDR5 RAM, dual M.2 slots for all your storage needs, and all that Wi-Fi 7 goodness for when the tech catches up. On paper, the numbers are solid. Geekbench 6 cores are 2,397 for single core, 13,000 for multi-core, and 33,000 for GPU OpenCL. Cinebench, 1,776 in single core and 16,370 in multi-core. But hey, benchmarks are one thing, the real world performance is what counts. So I fire up DaVinci Resolve for some 4K editing and it handled everything without a hitch. Mixing clips, adding music, no problem. I even made the intro to this very video on it. Today we're checking out rendering 4K material took about 20 seconds. Not the fastest, but definitely solid for 4K editing. There are three modes, energy saving, balance and performance. Stick with performance mode, their cooling system is excellent. Minisforum's phase change liquid metal cooler keeps it running quietly even under heavy load. Wondering how it holds up for gaming? Let's run a few tests and see. For older titles, the X70i does well. At 1080p with high settings, it runs Assassin's Creed Valhalla at around 30fps, smooth, with no major frame drops. At 2K though, you'll notice some lag and drops, but switching to medium graphics settings hits the sweet spot. With Forza Horizon, it's a similar story, smooth on high graphics at 1080p or medium graphics at 2K. At 4K, it remains playable, but the frame rate might drop to around 25fps. However, at 2K on medium settings, the Intel Arc maintains a solid 30fps. The thermal performance is impressive with efficient heat dissipation through the vents, and you can monitor temperatures on the mini display, a pretty cool feature. For something more demanding like Starfield, you'll need to stick to low settings at default HD for smooth gameplay. If you push it to high or ultra, the frame rate drops to a slideshow like 12fps, which is definitely unplayable. So sticking to minimal settings is probably the best approach. The GPU during gaming runs at max capacity, but the PC stays cool and quiet with fan noise around 40 decibels. Overall, this mini PC is great for daily use and light gaming, but it's not built for top tier performance in most demanding games. Powerful, but not high-end gaming rig. So here's the bottom line. The Minisforum AtomMan X70i is a solid, powerful mini PC with sleek design and unique features, earning an 8.5 out of 10. Not perfect, but here's why. It's not the cheapest option out there, starting at $629 US for the bare bones and $849 US fully loaded. There are cheaper AMD Ryzen alternatives with similar performance. Plus, the integrated Intel Arc graphics are not ideal for demanding games, and no Thunderbolt limits external GPU options, unless you're ready to dive into the Oculink. So this PC is perfect for basic video editing, light gaming, and anyone who values compact size and premium design. If you're willing to pay a bit more for a future-proof, well-engineered mini PC, this one's definitely worth considering. But if you're on a tight budget or need Thunderbolt, there are obviously other options. And that's a wrap. If you found this helpful, hit like, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys on the next one.